Hello Grinders and welcome to my video once again. So last week was kind of slow because I didn't play much. I had some personal issues that there's no reason to talk about, but everything is okay now, so we're good to go, and this week we'll play again a lot, and right now we're making our video and everything's okay again. So first of all, I would like to thank you for how you received my last video about the Tikuk High Roller Hunt. It was a very interesting video for me, and I'm really happy that you think the same about what I made. So this was the reason I decided to kind of change a little bit things and how I'm doing my videos. For now on, my plan is to focus a little bit more on strategy and less on personal stuff. As I said, the previous week was nothing important happened, and my volume kind of sucked, and I played about 150 tournaments, which is not good, obviously. I'm sticking to my plan. I will keep on playing MTT SMGs and MTTs. My current strategy is to play MTT SMGs with 100 buy-ins and MTTs with 200 buy-ins. Although this the past Sunday I took some shots and I tried to play the bigger 7.5, but I didn't actually paid the buy-in because I bought a ticket with points, and also I played the Sunday Spark, which is a $1 rebuy 3x turbo, which it's not that it's that much expensive, but it could be really expensive. If you make a lot of rebuys, you will pay a lot of money, and it is obviously out of my background. The good thing is that I managed to reach the add-on with just the buy-in. I didn't make a single rebuy, so that was good. And what we're going to see today is a series of hunts from 2.2 turbo, where I reached the final two tables on last Friday. I busted out on 18th place, and there was some hunts that I would like to show you on this tournament. I want to show you how much history against other players affects our decisions, and how we play specific hands, and it would be really interesting, I think. So after that, after the video, after the part with the analysis, I want to present you a hand where I will leave the discussion up to you. I will show you all the facts of the hand, and I want to let you decide what we're going to do. And on the video of the next week, I will answer the... not answer, I will show you what happened finally, and what decision I did take on the hand that I showed the previous week. So let's see first the hands from the 2.2 turbo. This is where we start. We're going to see a series of hands from the 2.5 turbo that I went deep on last Friday. As this is a turbo event, of course, you know that we're mostly playing solve or fold, so there are some of the hands that are not really important that I'm going to skip them quickly, but we're going to stay more on the important hands. We start with this hand, with 8s, of course it's an obvious solve with 18 big blinds, and we take the blinds and the antes. Also, I want you to take notice at this player, and even though we have only 11 hands from him, we can understand some things about how he plays by the small number of hands that we have him in our table. This is the first hand we see him solve from the button with 16 almost big blinds. This is the very next hand where he solves again with 18 big blinds from the cutoff. Nothing important here from these hands.
This is another hand where it's a clear solve for us. We have 16 big blinds and we're on the hijack, and it's profitable to solve. We get called from the short stack, and we didn't win. The next hand is this small pocket pair, and we obviously have to solve it. The guy we talked about calls us with king jack suited, and we double up. And this is the hand that it is the most important. This I think that this is a move that not many people do. If you're just now starting to learn how to play poker and stuff like that, this may this is not in your repertoire probably. But let's see. This guy, we talked about solves from the hijack, and based on what we've seen till now, we're going to suppose that he's solving somewhere around Nash. He may be solving according to the Nash equilibrium exactly, but we're not sure about that. But to make our calculations, we have to make some assumptions. So I have the hand here on the ICMizer that I have shown you also in the last video. Let's see what happens if he solves Nash. He's supposed to be solving about 30% of his hands, and this is his range, pretty much. And what we should do with ace 9 off? It is a profitable call, and it's going to give us half a big blind. It's not that this is a big win, and I think that if you are playing turbo tournaments, you have to kind of take those small edges against your opponents. If you're playing tournaments with a deeper structure, it is better for you. If you believe that you have an edge against your opponents, it is better to kind of wait for spots that are going to give you more expected value and not take so marginal spots. But turbo tournaments, I think it's really important to take all spots that you have edge, and they are plus EV. Also here you can see I have this TXT. This TXT explains some of the numbers of the hat that I use. Here you see only numbers, so it's obviously you cannot understand what those numbers mean. And if you want to see something, then you can check out these numbers. This the legend here, and explains in each row what each number means. If you don't understand something of that, you can always ask me on the comments of the video or on my Facebook page, where I will upload this video to, and you can ask me what this means, and I will reply to you as soon as I can. So on this hand, we made the call, but the player of the big blind called too. We hit an ace on the flop, but unfortunately the player on the big blind had the better kicker, and the player on the hijack was right where we suppose he will be. He's solving 7-8 suited, is into his Nash solving range, and when you see this kind of solve from a player with this stack, I think it is obviously that he's solving his Nash range. About three hands later, we busted this tournament on 18th place, as I said. We hit 10 jack on the hijack minus one on middle position, and we solved, which is also a solve, a profitable solve. But the player woke up with 8 jack, and we lost this tournament. So the quiz for this week is from another interesting hand that we played. It's from the same tournament, and we pick up ace jack on the big blind with 13 big blinds, and let's see how the action goes. This is a little bit different than the other hands we discussed, because right now we're facing a raise and a solve, and not only a solve, an open solve. So here you can see the numbers from our opponents, and you can check here the legend to understand what those mean. And also, I would like to discuss with you what our decision should be now. So for this week, I will leave it up to you. Please comment on this video or on my Facebook page about what you think is the optimal move in this situation. And that's it for the quiz.
So that's it for today. Thank you everybody so much for watching. I hope you liked my video. I will be really happy if I see you replying on my YouTube page or on my YouTube channel or on my Facebook page, because if we discuss hands like those, I think this is the best way for us to get better. And what I do is not only for myself, but for myself. I don't want only me to get better, I want also you to get better, and if we don't discuss hands, this is never going to happen. So please like, subscribe on my channel, like my videos, and share them with your friends if you believe that they're worth it. So thanks for watching, and I will see you next week.